All India Radio presents Morning News. Good morning, I'm Tanvi Taneja and with me is VC Pramod. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says there is global optimism towards India as it offers a perfect combination of openness, opportunities and options. Prime Minister to lay foundation stone for Manipur water supply project through video conferencing today. Communications and Information Technology Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad emphasizes the need for building trustworthy artificial intelligence systems that can transform society. 14-day complete lockdown to come into force in Manipur from this afternoon. And centre to release over 300 crore rupees as first installment under flood management program to Assam. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that there is global optimism towards India as it offers a perfect combination of openness, opportunities and options. Delivering the keynote address at the India Ideas Summit hosted by the US-India Business Council, USIBC, yesterday, Prime Minister Modi noted that in the last 6 years, efforts have been undertaken to make the Indian economy more open and reform-oriented.
India is contributing towards a prosperous and resilient world through the clarion call of an Atmanirbhar Bharat. And for that, we await your partnership. Today, there is global optimism towards India. This is because India offers a perfect combination of openness, opportunities, and options.
Hailing India as a land of opportunities, the Prime Minister said there are extensive opportunities to invest in a variety of sectors in the country. He said there are about 500 million active internet users in the country now and over 500 million more people are being connected. He also mentioned opportunities in frontier technologies of 5G, big data analytics, quantum computing, blockchain and Internet of Things. Speaking about the historic reforms recently undertaken in the agriculture sector, the Prime Minister said that there are opportunities to invest in areas including agriculture inputs and machinery, agriculture supply chain, food processing sector, fisheries and organic produce.
The options to invest in India are extensive. India invites you to invest in the hard work of our farmers. There are investment opportunities in agriculture inputs and machinery, agriculture supply chain management, ready-to-eat items, fisheries and organic produce. To grow more streams of revenue, the best time to tap investment opportunities in Indian agriculture sector is now.
Noting that the healthcare sector in India is growing faster than 22% every year and the progress of Indian companies in production of medical technology, telemedicine and diagnostics, the Prime Minister said, now is the best time to expand investment in Indian healthcare sector. The Prime Minister also listed several other sectors which offer tremendous opportunities to invest like energy, infrastructure, roads, highways and ports, civil aviation, among others. He mentioned that India is raising the FDI cap for investment in defence sector to 74% and two defence corridors have been established to encourage production of defence equipments and platforms. The Prime Minister also talked about India's rise in ease of doing business rankings of the World Bank. The Prime Minister highlighted that even during the pandemic, India has attracted foreign investment of more than $20 billion between April and July this year. The Prime Minister said that India has what is needed to power the global economic recovery. Calling USA and India as natural partners, he said this partnership can play an important role in helping the world bounce back faster after the pandemic.
We all agree that the world is in need for a better future, and it is all of us who have to collectively give shape to the future. I firmly believe that our approach to the future must primarily be a more human-centric one. Our growth agenda must place the poor and vulnerable at the core.
Reaching out to the American investors, he said that there has never been a better time to invest in India. The Prime Minister congratulated the USIBC on its 45th anniversary this year. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar has said that India and the US have the ability by working together to shape the world. Participating in the India Ideas Summit yesterday, hosted by US-India Business Council virtually, Mr. Jaishankar said India and the US are working on maritime security, counter-terrorism, connectivity, how to respond to the coronavirus pandemic, issues like climate change and knowledge economy. He said India and the US need to resolve the pending problems in trade relations and move into something bigger.
I would give a lot of emphasis to resolving our trade problems, trying to take sort of the journey into a higher gear than it has been before. I do believe it's very possible because I'm very wired to what's going on the trade side.
United States Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has said that New Delhi is an important partner and a key pillar of President Donald Trump's foreign policy. In his virtual keynote address to the annual India Ideas Summit of the US-India Business Council, USIBC, yesterday, Mr. Pompeo described India as one of the few trusted, like-minded countries and said, India is a rising U.S. defense and security partner in the Indo-Pacific and also at the global level. He said the United States desires a new age of ambition in its relationship with India. Mr. Pompeo said the U.S. has invited Prime Minister Narendra Modi to the next G7 meeting to be hosted by President Trump. Navies from the U.S., India, Australia, Japan and France have been deepening their mutual cooperation in the Indo-Pacific region in view of China's growing attempt to expand military influence in the resource-rich region.
United States has ordered the closure of the Chinese consulate in Houston by tomorrow. In a statement, U.S. State Department spokesperson Morton Okudas said the closure was due to unfair trade practices, theft of American jobs and other egregious behavior. She also said that the closure was necessary to protect Americans' intellectual property and private information. According to Houston media reports, fire was reported from the Chinese consulate in Houston after the closure of Chinese consulate in the city. The move comes close on the heels of the claims by U.S. Justice Department that China-aided hackers stole intellectual property rights worth millions of dollars from COVID-19 vaccine. It has also been alleged that they stole trade secrets from companies across the world. Turkmenistan has been granted observer status by the World Trade Organization WTO General Council. A WTO spokesperson said yesterday that Turkmenistan has become the last former Soviet republic to establish formal ties with the trade body. The Central Asian country filed a request for observer status in May and expressed willingness to trigger the talks on accession to the WTO within 5 years. Neighboring Central Asian countries, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyz Republic, Tajikistan and Afghanistan have acceded to the WTO, while Uzbekistan has been in and off negotiations on WTO accession since 1994. Indian mission in the United Arab Emirates has urged the nationals to take advantage of the fine waiver scheme for all foreign residents and leave the Gulf country without paying any fines till the 17th of August this year. The government of UAE has announced a fine waiver scheme for all foreign residents whose visas have either expired before 1st of March 2020 or whose stay has not been regularized in the country as on date. As per the waiver scheme, valid till the 17th of August, they can be permitted to leave the country without making any payment of fines for the period. In a statement issued yesterday, the Indian mission said all such cases of Indian nationals are required to be approved by the competent UAE authorities and to be coordinated through the Embassy of India, Abu Dhabi, and through Consulate General of India in Dubai. For doing so, the concerned persons need to send an application, including details of their passport, local contact mobile number, email address, visa copy, etc., with supporting documents to ca.abudhabi@mea.gov.in and con2.dubai@mea.gov.in. The application should be sent at least 7 working days before the intended date of travel to India.
Minister for Communications and Information Technology Ravi Shankar Prasad has emphasized the need for building trustworthy artificial intelligence systems that can transform society. In the wake of pandemic like COVID-19, Mr. Prasad strongly emphasized the need for building a resilient global supply chain. He shared the vision of Prime Minister Narendra Modi for making India an attractive destination for investment closely integrated with global supply chains. He was speaking at the virtual meeting of G20 Digital Economy Ministers yesterday. It was hosted by Saudi Arabia, which is holding the presidency of G20. The minister said that India will soon put in place a robust personal data protection law. He said it will not only address data privacy-related concerns of citizens, but also ensure availability of data for innovation and economic development. Mr. Prasad told the ministers of the G20 nations that it is time to acknowledge that digital platforms anywhere in the world have to be responsive and accountable towards the sovereign concerns of countries, including defense, privacy, and security of citizens. Mr. Prasad also informed the global gathering about how India, under the leadership of Prime Minister, has managed the COVID-19 crisis far better than many other countries. The Union Minister shared India's digital innovations that helped in the fight against COVID-19. He also spoke about initiatives like Arogya Setu mobile app, geofencing system for monitoring quarantined patients, and COVID-19 Savdhan bulk messaging systems during the meeting. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will lay the foundation stone for Manipur water supply project today through video conferencing. Governor, Chief Minister of Manipur, his cabinet colleagues, MPs and MLAs are expected to join the program from Imphal. The centre initiated the Jal Jeevan mission to provide safe and adequate quantity drinking water to every rural household of the country by 2024 with the motto Har Ghar Jal. The mission is based on a community approach to water and has information, education and communication as key components of the mission. It looks to create a Jan Andolan for water, thereby making it everyone's priority. There are about 19 crore households in India and only 24% have fresh water household tap connections.
You are listening to the Morning News on All India Radio. A reminder of the headlines before we move on. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says there is global optimism towards India as it offers a perfect combination of openness, opportunities and options. Prime Minister to lay foundation stone for Manipur water supply project through video conferencing today. Communications and Information Technology Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad emphasizes the need for building trustworthy artificial intelligence systems that can transform the society. 14-day complete lockdown to come into force in Manipur from this afternoon. Centre to release over 300 crore rupees as first installment under flood management program to Assam. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts.
In Manipur, complete statewide lockdown and curfew will begin from 2 p.m. today for 14 days. A state cabinet meeting chaired by Chief Minister was held last evening, reviewed the COVID-19 situation in the state and decided to implement the complete lockdown as a preventive measure. More from our correspondent.
After the emergency cabinet meeting held last evening, Manipur Chief Minister N. Biren Singh announced that there will be 14 days lockdown in entire area of Manipur from this afternoon. The Chief Minister said that the decision to implement complete lockdown has been taken after some people who do not have travel history were found positive of COVID-19 in the state. He said the government will enforce the lockdown and curfew strictly and appeals people of the state to cooperate the decision of the government. J.J. Thokson from Imphal for AIR News.
The West Bengal government has decided to impose a twice-a-week lockdown in the state till August to control the rise in COVID-19 cases. The state's caseload rose to 47,030 and death toll mounted to 1,182 till Tuesday. The state government has announced that this week's bi-weekly lockdown will be imposed today and on 25th of July. A meeting chaired by Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee arrived at this decision prompted by expert opinion that stressed the need to break the chain of infection. In Madhya Pradesh, the number of COVID-19 cases in the state climbed to 24,842, while the death toll mounted to 770. With a sudden spike in the number of coronavirus cases in the last 1 week in Bhopal, The state government announced a 10-day lockdown in the state capital from 25th of July. More in this report.
Officials said that average positivity rate in Bhopal in the last 7 days was 10.23%, which required the government to intervene. Home Minister Narottam Mishra told reporters that e-passes will be required like earlier lockdown for travel to Bhopal.
ऐसा तय किया है कि 25 तारीख को सुबह से 10 दिन के लिए पूरा भोपाल लॉकडाउन रहेगा.
He said that next cabinet meeting will be held through video conferencing. Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan said in a tweet that during this period, the uninterrupted supply of essential commodities including fruits, vegetables, medicines and milk will continue. Sanjeev Sharma, AIR News, Bhopal.
In Gujarat, the number of COVID-19 cases rose to 51,485 yesterday after 1,020 fresh cases were reported in the last 24 hours. According to State Health Department, the number of recoveries is also increasing rapidly. So far, 37,240 patients have fully recovered from the coronavirus infection. As many as 837 patients were discharged from various hospitals in a single day. A report from our correspondent.
Rising number of cases in Surat is a matter of concern for the state. The district reported the highest 256 cases yesterday. Surat now has 11,128 cases, while the death toll in the district crossed 500 mark yesterday. So far, 2,229 patients have lost their lives due to coronavirus in the state. In Ahmedabad, number of cases has dipped for the last few days as part of its strategy to involve private hospitals in the fight against COVID-19. Ahmedabad Municipal Corporation yesterday notified 4 more private hospitals as designated COVID hospitals. Aparna Khun, AIR News, Ahmedabad.
In Gujarat, around 1,500 self-financed schools have decided to discontinue online education from today. The decision came after the Education Department issued a notification which restricted self-financed schools from charging fees from the parents until the schools reopen. The notification directed self-financed schools not to collect tuition fees from students as long as they remain shut due to COVID-19 pandemic. It said no school shall expel students of class 1 to 8 for not depositing tuition fees during this period as per the order of the Gujarat High Court. Meanwhile, Self-Finance School Management Education said the school management is finding it difficult to pay salaries of teachers and non-teaching staff without charging fees from parents. Our correspondent reports that a public interest litigation has already been filed in the Gujarat High Court seeking a direction to private schools not to charge fees other than tuition fees and not increase fee for the 2020-21 academic session.
Maharashtra Health Minister Rajesh Tope said that the state government is planning to set up a single command centre to oversee coronavirus bed management in hospitals in the Mumbai metropolitan region, which includes Mumbai, as well as surrounding satellite cities in Thane, Palghar and Navi Mumbai. The centre could come up either in Thane or Navi Mumbai with the help of the Mumbai Metropolitan Region Development Authority, MMRDA. Maharashtra has reported its highest single-day spike of 10,576 cases yesterday, taking the state's tally to 3,37,607. More from our correspondent.
Health Minister Rajesh Tope said he has discussed the issue with Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray and Thane Guardian Minister Eknath Shinde, and both supported the idea of single command center to solve the problem of bed availability in MMR. The minister said there is already a single command center in Mumbai for testing and bed management. Its dashboard gives real-time data on availability of beds across the city, as no one gets a bed for COVID-19 treatment directly in Mumbai, but the person has to call the help line or the ward level war room. He said, but in MMR, it has been seen that beds at field hospitals in Thane city were empty, while other satellite cities were facing shortage of beds. Devapriya Bhattacharji, AIR News, Mumbai.
In Karnataka, the total number of COVID-19 positive cases breached the 75,000 mark, with 4,764 new cases being reported yesterday. A total number of 1,780 patients recovered and were discharged from various hospitals. The total recovered patients has gone up to 27,239 in the state. Our correspondent tells us more.
Among the new COVID positive cases, 2,050 cases were reported from Bengaluru. 47,069 active COVID positive cases are prevailing in the state. The total number of deaths has gone up to 1,519. The total test has increased to 11,12,874. Meanwhile, the trade body, Federation of Karnataka Chamber of Commerce and Industry, has said that its traders will be forced to go on agitation if the government does not allow markets and business establishments around Bengaluru Central District to operate their business. The area right now is under containment zone. R. Murthy, AIR News, Bengaluru.
The centre has told the Madras High Court that 58 special flights are scheduled to operate from abroad to Tamil Nadu under the Vande Bharat mission. In response to a petition by the DMK, the additional Solicitor General told the court that the flights are scheduled from yesterday to the 5th of August. 41 of the special flights will be operated to Chennai and others to Trichy, Coimbatore and Madurai airports. The total COVID-19 infection in Tamil Nadu has surpassed the 1,86,000 mark with 5,845 new cases reported yesterday. The active caseload is over 51,700. Testing has been augmented further in the state. More from our correspondent.
Testing in Tamil Nadu has gone up to a little over 60,000 samples on a single day yesterday. The cumulative total so far is estimated to be nearly 21 lakh samples. A unique feature is that all the tests accounted were done using the RT-PCR kits, not the antibody test. In places where the positivity rate is very minimal, the administration is planning to employ pool testing. In a pool of samples, if one turns positive, then all the members of the pool can be individually tested. Jay Singh, AIR News, Chennai.
In Telangana, 1,554 fresh coronavirus positive cases were reported yesterday, taking the total number of COVID-19 cases in the state to almost 50,000. So far, the state reported 49,259 COVID-19 cases. Nine more persons died yesterday, taking the total deaths relating to COVID-19 in the state to 438.
Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has asked Additional Chief Secretary Medical Education to review the health facilities for COVID patients in Kanpur city. The state government has also decided to establish centres for testing at various places in cities where antigen and RT-PCR tests will be conducted. The state is having 20,825 active cases spread in all the 75 districts. A report.
Additional Chief Secretary Health Amit Mohan Prasad said that teams of teachers, doctors and administrative officials are doing intensive contact tracing in Lucknow city. Active COVID patients in city are 3,048 with 310 new cases in last 24 hours. He said that a rapid response team will inspect the homes of the patients to see whether they fulfill the condition for home isolation. Home quarantine patients have to carry pulse oximeter and infrared thermometer. A toll-free number has been issued for persons in home isolation, that is 1-800-180-5146. Officials have been asked to strengthen the telemedicine services in hospitals and encourage the use of online OPD service e-Sanjeevani of Union Health Ministry. People will also be able to get medicines from government hospitals by showing the slip of e-Sanjeevani. Sushil Chandra Tiwari, AIR News, Lucknow.
Uttarakhand reported its highest single-day spike of 451 corona positive cases yesterday. Maximum of 204 cases were reported from Haridwar district. Majority of new cases were employees of an industrial unit in Sidkul or their contacts. State capital Dehradun also reported 43 new cases, whereas 73 new cases were found in Nainital, as per the health bulletin release, which was released last night.
In Punjab, the spike in positive cases of COVID-19 is being seen from past few days. Yesterday, 414 new persons tested positive for the virus and 252 patients were also discharged from various hospitals post-recovery. Six patients lost their lives. With this, the number of persons testing positive so far has risen to 11,301, out of which 7,641 patients have been cured and 269 have died due to the infection. Participating in AIR live phone-in program on COVID-19, Dr. Aparna Agarwal, Professor of Medicine at the Lady Harding Medical College, said it is believed that herd immunity can be developed only when around 45% of the population recovers from the infection.
हर्ड इम्यूनिटी अभी शायद डेवलप नहीं हुई है. पहले कह रहे थे कि 2/3 आबादी अगर इन्फेक्ट होए तो हर्ड इम्यूनिटी होगी, लेकिन अभी लोगों का मानना है मे बी अबाउट 40-45% लोग तक अगर इन्फेक्ट होएंगे शायद हर्ड इम्यूनिटी आ जाए.
Dr. Agarwal also explained the reason of low COVID-19 infection rate in women as compared to men.
सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट, ये वायरस हमारी बॉडी में एंटर करता है ACE2 रिसेप्टर्स के जरिए, और ACE2 रिसेप्टर्स पुरुषों में ज्यादा होता है और महिलाओं में कम होता है. सेकेंड, महिलाओं में कुछ हॉर्मोन्स होते हैं ईस्ट्रोजेंस और प्रोजेस्ट्रॉल, वो बॉडी को प्रोटेक्ट करते हैं. ईस्ट्रोजेंस ACE रिसेप्टर्स कम करते हैं, प्रोजेस्ट्रॉल एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी होते हैं, तो प्रोबेबली वो साइटोकाइन स्टॉर्म कम करते हैं, जो ये बीमारी सिवियर करने का एक इम्पोर्टेंट तरीका है.
In order to effectively manage the relief and rehabilitation work in flood-hit Assam, Union Jal Shakti Minister Gajendra Singh Shekhawat assured to release an amount of 346 crore rupees immediately from his ministry to Assam as the first installment under flood management program. The Union Minister conveyed it to Assam Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonowal during a video conference held last evening. The Chief Minister had appealed to the Union Minister to allocate funds to the state government to strengthen 5,000 kilometers of embankments built since 1951 in the state, which would now be turned into road-cum-embankments. In Bihar, flood situation continues to be grim in the affected districts. Over 6,50,000 people have been affected by floods in 10 districts, including Sitamarhi, Sheohar, Gopalganj and Muzaffarpur. The worst affected districts are Darbhanga, West Champaran and Supaul. 14 people have lost their lives in rain-related incidents. Now let us take a look at the weather updates for today. National capital Delhi may see a generally cloudy sky with light rain. Minimum temperature was recorded at 24 degrees Celsius, while the maximum is expected to be around 35 degrees. Mumbai will have a generally cloudy sky with light rain. The city had a minimum temperature of 27 and will have a maximum of around 33. In Chennai, the temperature will hover between 27 and 35. The city will also see a generally cloudy sky with light rain. Kolkata will have a generally cloudy sky with few spells of rain or thunder showers with a minimum temperature of 26. The maximum temperature will be nearly 31. In Jammu and Kashmir, the minimum temperature was 26 in Jammu, while maximum will be around 34. The city is likely to have a partly cloudy sky with possibility of rain or thunderstorm or dust storm. In Srinagar, the temperature will hover between 16 and 30 degrees Celsius. The city is expected to see a mainly clear sky becoming partly cloudy towards afternoon or evening. In Gilgit, the minimum temperature was recorded at 16, while the maximum will be around 29. It is expected to have a mainly clear sky becoming partly cloudy towards afternoon or evening. Muzaffarabad may also see a mainly clear sky becoming partly cloudy towards afternoon or evening. The place had a minimum temperature of 20, while maximum will be around 32 degrees. In Ladakh, the minimum temperature was 16 in Leh, while maximum will be around 28. The city is likely to have a mainly clear sky becoming partly cloudy towards afternoon or evening.
Today is National Broadcasting Day. On this day in 1927, the first ever radio broadcast in the country went on air from Mumbai station under a private company, the Indian Broadcasting Company. On the 8th of June 1936, the Indian State Broadcasting Service became All India Radio. Since 1927, radio has been an important part in the people's life in India. On the occasion, Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar has extended his wishes to all the people. And now an overview of today's newspapers. Invest in a country you can trust. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's strong pitch to US investors at the India Idea Summit gets highlighted by several dailies. PM had 50 plus meetings in 1 month on reforms with 1,000 man hours logged, writes the Times of India. The Hindustan Times reports Delhi to conduct sero survey every month to determine the extent of COVID spread. Testing times for plasma banks as demand goes through the roof, headlines the Business Standard. The Mail today highlights that many cured patients and brokers sell their lifesaver plasma to critically ill for up to 5 lakh rupees amid huge demand supply gap.
And now, before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says there is global optimism towards India as it offers a perfect combination of openness, opportunities and options. Prime Minister to lay foundation stone for Manipur water supply project through video conferencing today. Communications and Information Technology Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad emphasizes the need for building trustworthy artificial intelligence systems that can transform society. 14-day complete lockdown to come into force in Manipur from this afternoon and center to release over 300 crore rupees as first installment under flood management program to Assam. And with that, we end the morning news. Have a nice day.